Almighty God, we give you thanks for these churches of the West Virginia Conferences, churches that are part of the state of West Virginia, churches that are part of Garrett County, Maryland, and then there's a few churches even across the lines in other states around us. We give you thanks for the witness and the presence of these congregations, places that do great mission and ministry, places that make disciples, places that give hope and light and love to the world. Oh God, we give you thanks for these churches, and not just those buildings. We give you thanks for the leadership, for as Dr. Dotson reminded us this morning, the church really is about the people. And where you reach people, church comes, and not the other way around. So Lord, we ask that you would continue to abide with and walk with the leaders, both lay and clergy, in the West Virginia Conference, that we might be found faithful to following the Great Commission and the Great Commandment, and working together to multiply the witness for Christ wherever we find ourselves, in our own backyards, and around the world. This we ask in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
I continue to be glad and to be proud to serving the West Virginia Conference as your bishop. The state of the West Virginia Conference Church is bright. It's bright. I want you to hear that. It's bright. In the midst of these anxious times in the larger church, I am grateful that you have worked with me to keep the focus where it should be, on Jesus Christ. Amen. And Christ's movement among us. Together, we continue to make disciples. Together, we continue to provide shelter and clothing and food and medical care to those whose lives have been disrupted by floods, by poverty, and by drug addiction. Together, we care for both the very young and the very old, seeking to advocate for the most vulnerable members of our society. Together, we continue to fight against racism and sexism and other isms, fulfilling our baptismal commitment to oppose the oppression and injustice of the world in whatever forms these things happen to take place. I am proud that together we continue to discover, to develop, and to deploy passionate spiritual leaders for the sake of Christ, and we continue to focus on being faithful members of the body who contribute our unique gifts to the building of God's kingdom. We've had some tremendously wonderful moments in the West Virginia Conference since last we met in our annual conference session. At the close of our last annual conference, we confirmed that we had attained our goal of reaching 2,400 new persons for Christ. Give yourselves a hand. That's double what the West Virginia Conference tends to report in professions of faith on an annual basis. Now, let me be clear. Some of those 2,400 have not yet officially joined one of our churches. So I would continue to ask you to focus. There are still 2,400 plus that we have not reached to make a profession in Jesus Christ. And every time we help someone to say yes to Christ, it's not just about saying yes to Christ. It's helping them to become disciples of Christ. We are not just to bring people to Christ, not just to bring people to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, but we're to walk alongside them, with them, into becoming disciples. To do this, we need to help clergy and laity to both identify and build effective discipleship systems for our congregations and the particular and vastly different context and cultures of our West Virginia and Garrett County congregations call us to examine how we put discipleship systems together in different ways that reflect our different contexts. We had some great teaching on how to do that with Dr. Dotson, both yesterday and today. So don't just take that material and put it into your personal growth folder. That information was meant for our congregation growth folders, our making disciples of Christ folders. Earlier this year, we began to foreshadow and live into this year's conference theme, innovative. In February, over 750 persons from around the conference gathered on one Saturday to learn what it takes and how to build intentional plans to move our congregations from a concentration and priority on membership to discipleship. For the first time ever, in 10 different places around the conference, people were connected by live stream to a training and resource event that was physically and tangibly taking place at Forest Burdett United Methodist Church. We had facilitators and our communications teams set up in all of these locations, and hundreds of people came together to better learn about discipleship systems so that they could not just lead people to Christ, but be equipped to walk them into discipleship and to walk themselves and their current disciples into deeper discipleship. Now, if you were a part of this innovative event, the membership to discipleship, would you please stand? Wow. We continue to respond to flooding, both the 2012 flooding, but also more recent flooding. And as other systems fail to keep the promises to help, our promises have remained firm. And we have put our prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness behind getting the least, last, lost, and the most devastated in our communities, not only back in safe and healthy homes, but we have also given families and communities who thought they had lost everything hope for the future. What a gift. What a gift. And a gift that keeps on giving life. If you have hope, then you are looking for a better tomorrow. If you've been part of the flood recovery process, would you please stand so that we might greet you and thank you for the flood recovery process. Racism and sexism, they're still rampant in our society. In the midst of this, West Virginia continues on developing intercultural competency. Again, we were at capacity for the Bishop's Summit on Diversity and Inclusion. More churches in the conference did a celebration of Native American Awareness Sunday this year than any other time we can look to in the past. For the first time this year, we recognized as a whole that we all needed to be a part of helping Black Methodists for Church Renewal. And we took up offerings around the entire conference to help in the work and the work in ministry and training that supports leadership development and supports leadership in congregations that are non-white members of our community and our connection. The West Wall. And today, you just took action on adding this particular offering as a regular part of the special offerings done annually in the conference. The West Virginia Conference took a bus to Washington, D.C., to the summit to dismantle racism. And we participated in the rally and the march. If you were a part of that bus trip combating racism, would you please stand? The West Virginia communications team is on the move as an award-winning team. Yeah. Our story is being told internally and externally in new, innovative ways. We are getting better at telling and sharing what Christ is doing here in West Virginia as individuals and as congregations. Our communications team won 5 awards from United Methodist Communications, and our own Deborah Coble was named Communicator of the Year. Deborah's in the back. Could you please turn and communications team stand so that we can greet you and thank you. Not only to help the conference, but you as individual congregations improve and strengthen your communications team. We celebrate new innovative ways of spreading the good news and reaching people for Christ. The restart of Johnson Avenue that Bridgeport United Methodist Church has done is significant, creating a multi-campus congregation. It's reaching out in new ways and taking places that some people thought had died and bringing resurrection and new life. Isn't that what you're about? Together Tuesdays, an outreach service taking place at a local pizza restaurant in Lewisburg under the leadership of previous Denman Award winner and associate Lewisburg UMC associate pastor, Reverend Bev Colombo, has brought hundreds of people together for Christ that the congregation didn't see regularly or at all in their Sunday worship services. Wow. In new ways. And then there is the story about one who will be recognized tomorrow, the Reverend Chip Bennett, and the whole community of Point Pleasant. Joint ministry of more than one of our congregations, doing innovative ministry by taking one of our church buildings that no longer has a Sunday morning worshiping congregation and opening it all week for those seeking help and support for substance use disorder, hosting AA and NA groups and more during the week. Can't you celebrate that? In Clarksburg, there's Dustin McCune, who has supported members of his congregation in the door-to-door community building ministry and developing a sober living duplex next to the church. Wow! And then there is Spruce Street, who has a lay-led ministry in the harm reduction program in downtown Morgantown. And the let's give them a hand too. And as you saw just a moment ago, church after church, congregation after congregation participated in the What If Lenten Study program and the challenge to begin to hear God's call to begin ministries in response to the opioid epidemic. I could go on and on. My timer is telling me my time is running short. New innovative young adult internships, we have them. Discovery New for our young adults. We have that new innovative ministry. Spring Heights Camp on the road. You saw a tape of that going. New and innovative ministry. A new and renewed partnership with this campus of West Virginia Wesleyan College. Churches that opened their doors and took care of our school children as our teachers fought for a decent wage and health care at pretty much a moment's notice. A groundbreaking at the House of the Carpenter that included the students from the entire elementary school on Wheeling Island. A new, yeah, you can clap for that. A new church and community worker in the Southern District working to alleviate poverty in new, innovative, and collaborative ways. The state of the United Methodist Church in West Virginia is pretty good. Pretty good. Sure, the United Methodist Church as a whole is in some anxious and unsteady times. However, I believe God is rejoicing that in the West Virginia Conference, through it all thus far, we have succeeded in keeping the main thing the main thing. Our neighbors as ourselves. We have fed the hungry. We have sheltered the homeless. We have clothed those who needed clothing. We've helped those addicted and afflicted. We've visited those bound by mental or physical prisons. We have been persons of the good news. Yeah. And my prayer is that the good news of Christ, shared and multiplied, will continue to be the narrative of this West Virginia Conference. Amen.